Assalamu alaikum children, welcome to the science class for grade 4. This is your Galaxy science course book. Today we are going to start our first lesson, that is plants, the producers. At the end of the lesson, you will be able to describe plants as the producers of food, identify the parts of leaf, describe the process of photosynthesis. As you all know, food is essential for us to live. As we all are living things, yes, we need food to live. Most of the food we eat comes from plants, yes or no? Plants themselves need food to live. Even plants are also living things, that's why they too need food to live. Now, where do plants get their food from? Yeah, green plants make their own food. So, they are called producers. It is the leaf that make their food for plants. Leaves are green in color. Yes or no? Most of the leaves will be green in color. So why the leaves will be green in color? Because due to the presence of natural green color substance called chlorophyll. So what will be present in the leaves? Chlorophyll will be present. Now what this chlorophyll will do? Chlorophyll helps the plants to make their food. Let us now study the parts of a leaf and understand how it makes food for the plant. So let's begin parts of a leaf. So the broad flat part of a leaf is called lamina. As you can see, yes, the broad part of a leaf is called lamina, or we can call it as leaf blade also. There are many tube-like structures on the leaf called veins. Okay, can you see this one? Yeah, veins. The main thick running through the middle of the leaf is called midrib. This, from the middle it's running, no? That is called midrib. The veins branching out from the midrib is called side veins. The tip of the leaf is called the leaf apex. This tip is called as leaf apex. The part of the leaf that attaches to the stem or branch is called leaf stalk. Observe the leaf using a magnifying lens. There are tiny holes. These holes are called as stomata. Those are present on the surface of the leaf. These holes allow air to enter or leave the leaf. So they help the plant to breathe. These holes are useful for taking breath. Observe leaves of different plants. You will realize that different plants have different kinds of leaves. We can generally identify a plant by looking at its leaf. Yes, mango plant leaf will be different than guava. Yes, another plant also. By seeing the leaf only, we can identify which plant it is. Now let's see how the preparation will be gone in the plants. So preparation of food in plant. Who will prepare the food? Obviously leaves. Yes, leaves prepare the food for a plant. So they are called the kitchen of a plant or food factory of a plant. Now let us understand the process by which leaves make the food. Yes. Let's begin. So what are the ingredients as we will prepare the food in our kitchen? We need some ingredients, yes? Water and that fire and everything should be there. Even the plant also needs some ingredients to prepare the food. Let's see what are the ingredients. So first thing, the leaves use carbon dioxide. Okay? Carbon dioxide from air enters the leaf through the stomata. From the surrounding, they'll take the carbon dioxide and water and minerals from the roots. The chlorophyll in the leaves traps the solar energy. And the chlorophyll, what the chlorophyll do? It traps the solar energy, sunlight. And the leaves then use this energy to convert the carbon dioxide, water and minerals into food. And they give out oxygen and water vapor. Hence, what is essential here? Chlorophyll and sunlight are essential for a plant to prepare the food. So what is released? Oxygen and water vapor releases. The above process can be explained in the equation. See, you can see in the equation. So what they are using? Carbon dioxide, water and minerals in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll. Finally, what they have prepared? The food plus as well as oxygen and water vapor. So, this is the preparation of food in a plant. This whole process, the presence of sunlight is essential for plant to make. Yes, this whole process is known as photosynthesis, through which plant make their own food. That process is known as photosynthesis. Here photo means light. Which light? Sunlight. And synthesis means making. Okay, making all this together is known as photosynthesis. So let us perform an activity to show that sunlight is essential for plants to make the food. Let's experiment it. So what is the aim? To show that green plants need sunlight to make the food. Without sunlight, they can't prepare the food. So what are the things required? Two potted rose plants. And what is the method? Take two healthy potted rose plants of the same type and size. Place one plant outside at a spot that receives sufficient sunlight, and the other, place the other plant in a dark cupboard. Now what you have to do? Observe the two plants after a week. What do you see? Yeah, you'll notice that the plant placed in the open looks healthy. However, the plant in the dark cupboard looks sick. Its green leaves have started to turn pale yellow and Why do you think this has happened? What's the reason behind that? Because in the dark cupboard, the plant did not receive any sunlight. In the absence of sunlight, the leaves cannot prepare the food. The lack of food caused the leaves of the plant to become pale and yellow. So finally, what you have understood from this experiment? That green plants need sunlight to make the food. Yes, that's it for today's video. Hope you have understood it very clearly. Till the next video, children, everyone, just revise it and take care. Goodbye.